Hello students, myself Ranjita Singh is here with another chapter of science, that is lesson number 13, according to the syllabus of April month, that is fun with magnets. As you have already discussed chapter number 1 in a form of assignment and chapter number 2 in a form of video lecture. Now I will explain you the chapter fun with magnets. The topics to be covered: what is magnet, discovery of magnet, types of magnet, shapes of magnet, properties of magnet, handling of magnet, uses of magnet. Magnet, you might have heard in Hindi, chumbak. Chumbak means magnet. This is a very important part of a science, and particularly in physics. You are going to study about magnet, magnetic field, magnetism, up to the higher classes. So this is the very basic introduction to you all about magnets. Let us discuss now. What is magnet? In simple language, a magnet is a material that can attract the metals, that is iron, cobalt or nickel. So this is the simple definition, but here you can see I have written a definition also in a form of that. A magnet is an object or a material that produced magnetic field. Magnetic field means when a magnet is kept and the particular region up to which it shows its presence or its magnetism. Magnetism means its power to attract the objects like iron, nickel and cobalt. That is called the magnetism. That is, if a material is attracted by the magnet, then it must contain one or more object. A magnet has two poles, that is called as North Pole and other is called South Pole. You all know our Earth is also having a magnet and it is also having poles, and that we call geographical North Pole and geographical South Pole. That you will study about these in geography. Types of material according to the properties of magnetism. Now we will say that these are two types of material. Magnetic material means the material which are get attracted towards the magnet are known as magnetic materials. And these are the metals like iron, nickel and cobalt. Non-magnetic materials, the materials which are not attracted towards the magnet when it is kept closer to it, are known as non-magnetic materials. Materials are leather, plastic, cloth, paper, all this. And certain metals also like copper, iron, these are also non-magnetic. They are not attracted by the magnet. So these all are called non-magnetic materials. And magnetic poles are having the maximum power of attraction. The ends are called magnetic poles. About the discovery of magnet, they said that magnets were discovered after a shepherd named Magnes accidentally got his iron stick stuck to a rock. It was later discovered that the said rock had magnetic property, was called magnetite, and this is the natural magnet named so after the shepherd. This is about the discovery of the magnet. Now the types of magnet, as I already told you, the naturally occurring form of magnet, that is the called natural magnet, and it is also called lodestone or magnetite, and it contains iron. Now with the advancement of technology, we are able to develop artificial magnet also, and they are also called man-made magnets. So this one of the method to develop artificial method is that a single touch method, that I will explain you. Now another one is that man-made magnets are also available and they are having different shapes. And about electromagnet, you will study in class 7th. Now this single touch method to make temporary magnet. For this we have to take a iron bar and we have to take one bar magnet, and we have to keep it on a table or a stand. The bar magnet is lifted from the other end and brought to the starting point again with the same pole of the bar magnet. You can see as it is showing in the figure. On repeating this process for at least 40 to 50 times, the iron strip will become a bar magnet with two poles, but it will be a temporary magnet and it will be not lasting for long time. Now I will tell you about the shapes of the magnet, the artificial magnets that are available in different shapes: bar magnet, horseshoe shaped magnet, needle magnet, cylindrical magnet, oval shaped magnet, ring magnet. Now I am giving you here some assignment part, that is you can do it and you can understand whatever I have explained you. What are magnets? Define magnetic and non-magnetic materials. What are the types of magnet? What are the different shapes of artificial magnets? Now let's continue with the properties of magnet. A magnet has poles. If in a bar magnet, if we talk about the two ends, we consider as the poles. That is, and that they always exist in pairs and it cannot be isolated. Like poles repel each other and unlike poles attract each other. A freely suspended bar magnet always rests in the north and south direction. Poles of magnet possess strong magnetism. So these are the basic properties of magnet. Now we are going to discuss these properties one by one. The poles of a magnet always exist in pairs. It means if you take a bar magnet that is having north pole and south pole, and if you cut it into two pieces, then the place from where you cut it, that will again become a new pole. Like for the first one, one side will become south pole and another side will become north pole. So again the poles become north pole and south pole, north pole and south pole. So we are not able to separate the poles. That's why we say that poles always exist in pairs. Now the next property that we are going to study, that is unlike poles. Unlike poles means different poles. If we are having two bar magnets and we bring north pole of one bar magnet near to the south pole of another bar magnet, they will show the attraction. They will move towards each other. But if we take like poles, if we take two bar magnets and we bring north pole of one bar magnet and north pole of another bar magnet close to each other, then they will move away from each other. It means they will repel each other. Okay, now let's discuss about the another property, that whenever the magnet is suspended freely, it is always resting in north and south direction. To explain you, let's do this activity. Place a stand on a table and take a bar magnet. Tie a thread at the middle of a bar magnet. Now suspend it freely from the stand and wait until the bar magnet comes to rest and observe the direction. Now observe the direction of the bar magnet and again disturb the magnet. Again wait until it comes to the rest. Once again observe the direction of the bar magnet. Repeat the same process 3 times or more times. Always we will see that the magnet rests in north and south direction. This is one of the very important property of a magnet. And due to this property only, in the earlier time, people were using magnet to find out the direction. Chinese were the first to develop the magnetic needle that shows the direction. Now let's discuss about it. Why it is always resting in north and south direction? As I already told you, Earth is also having a magnet. You can see the picture here that is showing a north and south pole, and that is called north geographic pole, and that is another one is called south geographic pole. So this way, whenever a bar magnet is suspended on the Earth, then it always shows north and south direction, because that the one end of the bar magnet that is already having one of the another pole, either north or south. So it will move towards the geographical north or south. It will seeking towards the geographical north pole or geographical south pole. That's why it always rests in north and south direction. That's why the compass is developed with this property. This is a small glass case containing a magnetized needle pivoted on a nail. The needle can rotate freely. Wherever it is kept, its needle always rests in north-south direction. Normally, the north pole of the needle is painted red or some other indication is given to identify north and south poles. So, this is how compass it works. Now, about poles of magnet. Another property says that the poles of magnet possess strong magnetism. We can observe a very interesting property that which is when we try to attract iron filings or any other magnetic object to the magnet, they always accumulate at the ends of the magnet, as you can see in the picture also. This is because near the poles, the magnetic field of a magnet is very strong. So these all are the basic properties of the magnet. Now we are going to discuss about the two more terms that are called demagnetization and self-demagnetization. These two comes when you will study about the precautions to be taken while handling a magnet. When heated, hammered or dropped from the height, magnets tend to lose their property. It means their magnetism will be destroyed. They become weak if they are not sorted properly, and hence bar magnets should be stored. Whenever we are keeping the bar magnets, it is always stored in a small box of a wood or there, and they're unlike poles facing the same side with the soft iron across, and this iron is called keeper with their ends. A piece of iron should be kept across the poles in case of horseshoe magnet also. Magnet should be kept away from computers, mobiles, television, etc. Magnet should be handled with care and they should be stored properly. Okay, now what is the meaning of demagnetization? Demagnetization means whenever a magnet is either heated, hammered or dropped from the height, it loses their property of magnetism. So that is called demagnetization. That's why we have to take care of the magnets whenever we are working with them. Now let's discuss about the uses of magnets. Magnets have several uses. Some of them are, nowadays credit cards, ATM cards and identity cards have a strip of magnetic material that stores information. Television and computer monitors uses magnets. Computer hard disk and audio video cassettes have magnetic materials that store information. Magnets are used in picking up substance from iron from scrapyard. And it is also used by the doctors also in different therapy also. So these are the certain uses of magnets. Now there is another assignment for you all, that is, define poles of the magnet, explain properties of a magnet, mention the uses of magnet, and here is a one activity for you all. You can easily do it. Thank you.